Faster we travel of data, we reach the indexing. When we see our book of database engineering, it is of 1500 pages. So particular, suppose I want the information about the indexing. Is it easy to find the indexing, whatever the information in 1500 pages book easily? No, it is very difficult to retrieve or search that particular part. Suppose I want the information about the transaction. So in that book, which is of such a number of pages, it is very difficult to identify or search the particular record. So in that case, we use the index. Now there are two types of indices in our book. Yes or no? Is there two indices in our book? Only a single index? One. No, there are two types of indices in most of the book. The first index that you can see with topic wise. Unit 1, and these are the topics that are given there. Unit 2, these are the topics, page numbers are given there. So if you know the topic, that I know that indexing and hashing is the chapter number 11. So I directly go in index chapter number 11, search the hashing page number something 400, 500, I directly go to that particular page. That is the use of front index. That is the use of front index. We call it as a front index in the case of our normal books. Along with that, there is another index, that is back index. Have you observed any time their back index on your book, in your book, sorry? As it is according to the alphabetic order, A, B, C, D, up to Z. So if I don't know anything about any topic, nothing I don't know, the book is given to you and ask you to find out the information about the index from this book. So if you don't know anything about the book and the particular topic, you can directly go for the back index. Words are given here, A to Z. You directly go for the I, then in I search one by one. Index, where it is index, page number is given there, multiple page numbers may be there, go for that particular page, you can get the information about the index. Similarly, suppose you are to find out the transaction, if you don't know the topics in detail, it is very difficult to use the front index. In that case, you can use the back index. A to alphabetically, go for T. In T again, alphabetically, so different words may be there which start with T. So go for the transaction, different page numbers are given. Directly you can go for that particular page and you got the information about the transaction. So in this way, the use of index, faster retrieval of the information. So you can write down in your notebook that indexing is normally used for, or the index mechanism is used to access desired data in faster way. Now, in file system or in our database system, how the index is appear or what are the contents of the index? In our book, as I have told that the particular record is given or the that topic is given, in front of that the page number is given. In the back index, the alphabetically words are given, in front of that page number is given. So what is that page number? And what is that keyword or the word is given? See, suppose I want to search for transaction. I want to search for transaction. So in the back index, I search alphabetically T. In T again, I search for transaction. And suppose there is given that page number 690. So what is this 690 and what is this transaction? In the same way, the index entries are there in database. So this is, we can say, a search key. This is, we can say, a search key. Accordingly, we search the record, and this is nothing but a point that points to the record with that search key. That points to the record with that search key. So search key is a say attribute or set of attributes used to look up the records in the file, and a pointer that points to the record with that search key. Means, for example, if we consider instructor ID आई जस्ट सर्च की एंड आई राइट हियर 1 2 एंड देन द पॉइंटर. सो व्हाट इज दैट पॉइंटर? दैट पॉइंटर पॉइंट्स टू द एक्चुअल रिकॉर्ड विद दैट सर्च की. मीन ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट इंडेक्स डिफरेंट एंड योर ओरिजिनल फाइल इज डिफरेंट. इंडेक्स फाइल इज डिफरेंट एंड योर ओरिजिनल फाइल इज डिफरेंट. सो इंडेक्स फाइल्स आर टिपिकली मच original file and these are stored in the database. These are stored in the database. Now see, for example, so remember that in index file the index record has two entries. One is the search key and second one is the pointer. Search key is the attribute or set of attributes. This way. So this is the original file, instructor file, and this is the index file. This is the original instructor file and this is the index file. And this is your instructor file. Many times the student confuse between the index file and original file. So always remember the index file has only two entries, the search key and the pointer. And the original file has all the records. Suppose I want to search a record with 1 to 1. So here in the index file, first I go for this 1 to 1. Okay, I go for this, and then follow the pointer. It points to the actual record with that search. Everyone clear? I mean by index file and the index entries. No. Simple concept. So index files are typically again much smaller than the original. Why? There are only two entries, two fields are there only, search key and the pointer, and that size is small. Do you understood the definition of index, index file, what are the index entries? There are two basic types of indices, ordered indices and hash indices. Ordered indices, the records are stored according to the search key. Okay, sorted order. If ID is used, according to ID, the records are used. If the name is used, according to name, the records are used. If the department name is used, according to department name, the records are stored. And hash indices, search keys are distributed uniformly to the bucket. That bucket concept we are going to study in hash. Using a hash function. So hash function is computed on the search key. Whatever the result, according to that the records are stored in the bucket. Now see, in this entire unit we are going to study the indexing with these different types. So as I already told that major two types, ordered indices and hash indices, ordered and hashing. Along with that B+tree and B-tree we are going to study. Ordered indices has mainly three types. Primary, if you want, you can draw this in your notebook. Ordered indices has mainly three types: primary index, secondary index, and multi-level index. All these are we are going to study in detail. Primary index has two types: dense index and sparse index. And hashing has two techniques: static and dynamic hashing. See, again, indexing mainly two types: ordered indices, hashing techniques, along with B+tree and B-tree. Ordered indices again divided into primary, secondary, and multi-level index. Primary index has two types: dense index and sparse index. And in hashing, static hashing and dynamic hashing. We call it as a buffer replacement policies. Means we perform some replacement, thrown the block from disk main memory to disk, and the block from disk to main memory is placed at that position. So that is known as buffer replacement policy. Now see. The next task of buffer manager. So, buffer replacement policies. The most of the system, when there is no room left in the buffer for a block, then a block must be removed from the buffer and it transferred to the disk, so that to make a place for a new block. In the most of the operating systems, which method is used? Least recently used method, that already you have studied in operating system. So most of the operating system use least recently used our LRU scheme. What is LRU? The block which is least recently used. The block which is not used recently or least recently used is returned back to the disk and is removed from the buffer. Is returned back to the disk and removed from the buffer. That is the simple policy used in the operating system. Do you understand what is LRU? Already you have studied, I think, in operating systems. Yes or no? Now see, along with that, there are two more conditions for the buffer replacement. What is that? One is the pinned block. So most recovery systems require that a block. See, read it, because this question normally asks for oral or for objective. Most recovery system require that a block should not be returned back to the disk while an update on the block is in progress. While the update on the block is in progress. For example, suppose I am updating some block. Okay. Suppose on the disk. On the disk, there is a block where the instructor information is stored. The block where instructor information is stored. And suppose the programmer executes a query update instructor set salary is equal to salary multiply with 0.05. So what it perform, it this instruction when it executes, it updates the salary of all instructors. So where block is? The block which contains the instructor information is in progress. This block is first transferred from disk to main memory, and in main memory it is executed. While it is in progress, such a block is not allowed to return back to the disk. Such a block is not allowed to be returned back to the disk. That is known as pinned block. See, once again, most recovery systems require that a block should not be returned back to the disk while an update on the block is in progress. Now, instructor block, the update is in progress. So, that block is not allowed to transfer from main memory to disk. So, in that case, it is known as pinned block. Everyone clear what is meant by pin block? Now, the next one, another forced output block. There are situations in which it is necessary to return back the block to the disk. Okay, from main memory to disk, even though the buffer space that it occupies is not required. This is called as force output of a block. Means the space occupied by that block in main memory is not required. Even if the block is transferred from main memory to disk, that is known as forcefully that block is transferred from main memory to disk, that is force output of a block. Is it clear these three concepts? First, simple policy that every operating system uses least recently used. Means the block which is referenced least recently is written back from main memory to the disk. Pinned block, the block which are in update or which are in the process of updation are not allowed to write back to the disk. So these are known as pinned block. And force output means even if the space occupied by the block is not required in main memory, that block is forcefully transferred from main memory to disk, that is called as a force output of a block. Is it clear to everyone? So that we can move to the next part. Now see another example, again it will be clear for you. Okay. Now see, along with this most least recently used, some other buffer replacement policies are used in the database. In most of the operating system, as I told you, that least recently used method is used, LRU scheme is used. But the database system is more powerful to predict the next block required than the operating system. Database system is more powerful than the operating system who predict the future reference. Which block is required in future, which block is not required in future. And according to that, there are different replacement policies again. One example we are going to see here. Suppose we execute the query, instructor natural join requirement. What happens in this? Every instructor tuple is attached with every department tuple. Every instructor tuple is attached. Suppose this is instructor and this is department. So every instructor tuple is attached with every other tuple of the department. So first tuple is attached with every other tuple of the department where instructor.id, sorry, department name is common, where instructor.department name is equal to department.department name. So every tuple of instructor attached with every other tuple of the instructor. Once first tuple is completed, it go for the next tuple attached with every other tuple of the instructor. Then the next tuple, then the next tuple, then the next tuple. So in this way, every tuple of the instructor attached with every other tuple of the department. Suppose we execute this instructor natural join department. What actual the instruction is executed, or in programming language, how we can execute, write it? For each tuple of the instructor do, for each tuple d of the instructor do, if the equality on those attributes which are common in both the relation, which is common in both the relation, in both the relation department name is common. So I dot department name is equal to d dot department name, and here we use another temporary variable x to store the result of the natural join. So x dot id is equal to I dot id. The instructor id goes first. Then x dot department name is equal to I dot department name, instructor department name. X dot name is equal to instructor name, salary, building, and the budget. So in the resulting relation of this, how many number of tuples are there? In the resulting relation, there are 5 tuples which are id, which is common in both the relation, appears only once. Then name, then if I dot department name, as it is a common in both the relation, instructor dot department name, we need to use the prefix. Then salary, bill id, department name, sorry, id, department name appears only once. Then building, okay, and then budget. So these 5 attributes appear in the result when we perform the instructor natural join, and these are stored in the new variable x that is only in this program. Simple. Every tuple of instructor attached with every tuple of the department, and the result is stored in the temporary variable x. Now see, observe which replacement policies are required in this case. This suppose instructor tuple and this is the department tuple. Block 1, now we know that the file is partitioned into fixed length storage unit, we call it as a block. Now block 1 contains 4 tuples, block 2 contains these 4 tuples, and block 3 contains these 4 tuples. Means in one block we can store the 4 tuples of instructor. Similarly, block 1 and block 2, so these first four tuples in the block 1, these 3 tuples are in the block 2 of the department. Now how the natural join operation executes? It attaches every tuple of the instructor with every other tuple of the department. So see how the operation is executed. This first tuple is attached with every other tuple of the instructor where department dot department, instructor dot department name is equal to department dot department. Once the operation of this tuple is completed, it goes for the next tuple. Then this tuple is attached with every other tuple of the instructor. Then the third tuple is attached with every other tuple of the department. Then fourth tuple of the instructor attached with every other tuple of the department. After completion of the entire block or the processing of the entire block, whether these tuples are required in future, yes or no? Have you understood my question? See once again. This tuple, first tuple of the instructor attached with every other tuple of the department. Then it go for the second tuple attached with every tuple with the department. Third tuple, fourth tuple. Now, once the processing of this entire block is completed, whether this block is required in future, yes or no, for the operation. I want the answer from you, yes or no, whether this block is required in future again. Fast. Yes or no? To be replaced. And the least recently used block is required. So that probability is known as most recently used. Means the most recently used block is transferred from the main memory to the disk. So these are the different buffer replacement policies. So if the question is asked you, write note on buffer replacement policies or buffer manager, you have to write down these things according to the marks, whatever the marks are there for the question. Everyone clear with this? So that here we complete the file organization part, which is unit number 10 from the book. So in file organization, what we have seen? In the file organization, we have seen what are the different physical storage media, then hierarchy of physical storage media such as primary, secondary and tertiary storage media, or you can say volatile or non-volatile. After that, we have seen there are two ways in which we can store the records, fixed length records and variable length records. And then we have seen the types of file organization, sequential, heap, hash and multi-table clustering file organization. After that, we have seen the sequential organization, multi-table file organization in detail, and then this buffer policies along with the buffer learning. So I forgot data dictionary storage. So that is the file storage and the techniques for used for file storage, unit number 10 from the book. Now we are going to move towards the next part, that is indexing and hashing, that is unit number 11 of the book. Is there any doubt regarding the file storage? So listen it again. If you have any doubt, the PPT, the videos till date, whatever the videos are there, already I have uploaded on the drive. You can refer it for practical. Also, I have uploaded the videos on drive. Now we move towards the next part, that is indexing and hashing. So indexing. What is the use of index? Can anyone tell me what is the use of index? For which purpose we use the index? In our book also there is an index. What is the use of index? Simple definition I have asked or simple question I have made. Thing is the correct. Data faster. Faster retrieval of data will reduce the indexing. When we see our book of database engineering, it is of 1500 pages. So particular, suppose I want the information about the indexing. Is it easy to find the indexing, whatever the information in 1500 pages book easily? No, it is very difficult to retrieve or search that particular part. Suppose I want the information about the transaction. So in that book, which is of such a number of pages, it is very difficult to identify or search the particular record. So in that case, we use the index. Now there are two types of indices in our book. Yes or no? Is there two indices in our book? Only a single index? One. No, there are two types of indices in most of the book. The first index that you can see with topic wise, unit 1, and these are the topics that are given there. Unit 2, these are the topics, page numbers are given there. So if you know the topic, that I know that indexing and hashing is the chapter number 11. So I directly go in index chapter number 11, search the hashing page number, something 400, 500, I directly go to that particular page. That is the use of front index. That is the use of front index. We call it as a front index in the case of our normal books. Along with that, there is another index, that is back index. Have you observed any time their back index on your book, in your book, sorry? As it is according to the alphabetic order, A, B, C, D, up to Z. So if I don't know anything about any topic, nothing I don't know, the book is given to you and ask you to find out the information about the index from this book. So if you don't know anything about the book and the particular topic, you can directly go for the back index. Words are given here, A to Z. You directly go for the I, then in I search one by one, index where it is index, page number is given there, multiple page numbers may be there, go for that particular page, you can get the information about the index. Similarly, suppose you are to find out the transaction, if you don't know the topics in detail, it is very difficult to use the front index. In that case, you can use the back index. A to alphabetically, go for T. In T again, alphabetically, so different words may be there which start with T. So go for the transaction, different page numbers are given. Directly, you can go for that particular page and you got the information about the transaction. So in this way, the use of index, faster retrieval of the information. So you can write down in your notebook that indexing is normally used for, or the index mechanism is used to access desired data in faster way. Now, in file system or in our database system, how the index is appear or what are the contents of the index? In our book, as I have told that the particular record is given or the that topic is given, in front of that the page number is given. In the back index, the alphabetically words are given, in front of that page number is given. So what is that page number and what is that keyword or the word is given? See, suppose I want to search for transaction. I want to search for transaction. So in the back index, I search alphabetically T. In T again, I search for transaction, and suppose there is given that page number 690. So what is this 690 and what is this transaction? In the same way, the index entries are there in database. So this is, we can say, a search key. This we can say a search key. Accordingly, we search the record, and this is nothing but a point that points to the record with that search key. That points to the record with that search key. So search key is a say attribute or set of attributes used to look up the records in the file, and a pointer that points to the record with that search key. Means, for example, if we consider instructor ID as a search key, and I write here 1 2 1 2 and then the pointer. So what is that pointer? That pointer points to the actual record with that search key. Means always remember that index is different and your original file is different. Index file is different and your original file is different. So index files are typically most original file, and these are stored in the database. These are stored in the database. Now see, for example, so remember that in index file, the index record has two entries. One is the search key and second one is the pointer. Search key is an attribute or set of attributes. So this is the original file, instructor file, and this is the index file. This is the original instructor file and this is the index file. And this is your instructor file. Many times the student confuse between the index file and original file. So always remember, the index file has only two entries, the search key and the pointer. And the original file has all the records. Suppose I want to search a record with 1 to 1. So here in the index file, first I go for this 1 to 1. Okay. I go for this. And then follow the pointer. It points to the actual record with that search. Everyone clear? I mean by index file and the index entries. No. Simple concept. So index files are typically again much smaller than the original. Why? There are only two entries. Two fields are there only, search key and the pointer, and that size is small. Do you understood the definition of index, index file? What are the index entries? There are two basic types of indices, ordered indices and hash indices. Ordered indices, the records are stored according to the search key. Okay. Sorted order. If ID is used, according to ID, the records are used. If the name is used, according to name, the records are used. If the department name is used, according to department name, the records are stored. And hash indices, search keys are distributed uniformly to the bucket. That bucket concept we are going to study in hash, using a hash function. So hash function is computed on the search key. Whatever the result, according to that, the records are stored in the bucket. Now see, in this entire unit, we are going to study the indexing with these different types. So as I already told, that major two types, ordered indices and hash indices, ordered and hashing. Along with that, B plus tree and B tree, we are going to study. Ordered indices has mainly three types. Primary, if you want, you can draw this in your notebook. Ordered indices has mainly three types: primary index, secondary index, and multi-level index. All these are we are going to study in detail. Primary index has two types: dense index and sparse index. And hashing has two techniques: static and dynamic hashing. See, again, indexing mainly two types: ordered indices, hashing techniques, along with B plus tree and B tree. Ordered indices again divide into primary, secondary, and multi-level index. Primary index has two types: dense index and sparse index. And in hashing, static hashing and dynamic hashing. Okay, so next lecture we will see. Actually, we will finish this, and then we will see the next part in the next lecture. Do you understood this part? See, again, I am asking. No one is answering today. What happened? It's a simple search key and pointer is there. Pointer points to that record with that search key. Now, indexing techniques evaluated on the basis of five types or five ways we can evaluate the index, whether it is a good indexing technique or bad indexing technique. The first one is access type. So, index technique we define according to the type of access. Means what? Finding the records with a specified attribute value. Means, for example, finding the records with a specified attribute value. For example, suppose I execute a query like this, select star student where id is equal to 101. So here we find the records with the specified value, attribute value. ID should be 101. Instead of that, suppose I write here, select star from student where total credits are greater than 6. So what happens? Here we find out all the records from credit 6 to whatever the maximum range 10. Means finding the records within the attribute value spelling range. So that are the access types. According to that index, we need to define access time. The time it takes to find a particular data item or set of items. How much time is required to find that data item? For example, in this, suppose I want to find a record with the ID is equal to 76543. So here I need to follow the pointer. Here I got the or locate the record. So that access time, what time is required to retrieve the record? Another example in that, suppose I want to find the record with department name computer science and ID 83821. So computer science follow the pointer, here it is the record. So that time, access time required to retrieve that particular record. Then insertion time, the time it takes to find the correct place to insert the new data item and the time it takes to update the index structure. Suppose here I want to insert a new record with 32222. So as I already told that for insertion, what we need to do? We need to find out the location. So that time also consider. Suppose after this, we need to insert it. But if there is a no space, I insert it in the overflow block and all these things. Now, 322 is there in the index? No, it is not there. Index means we need to insert in the index also. Correct? So 322 index also we need to update. So insertion time, it includes the time it takes to find the correct place to insert the new data item and time it takes to update the index structure also we need to update. Similarly, deletion time, the time it takes to find the data item to be deleted and also we need to update the index structure. Means for example, suppose I delete the 2222. I want to delete a record with 2222. So first I need to identify the location where the particular record is stored, follow the pointer. Here I got this record, delete the record. Once I delete the record, I need to delete the index also, record index entry also. So that time, deletion time, the time it takes to find the item to be deleted and the time it takes to update the index structure. And space overhead, another that technique in indexing technique we need to consider is the space required to store the index structure. Additional space. Why? Because the original file is different and the index file is different. So we need to store that file also. So that additional space also we need to consider while we are choosing any. So indexing mechanism, it is used for purpose to speed up the access, to retrieve faster retrieval of the data, we use the index. As we use the index in our regular books, in the same way, indexing mechanism is used in the database. So index file is a separate file and the original your file, whatever that data file is separate. So for example, I have shown you, suppose this is your instructor file and this is your index file. So index file is separate and your instructor or the original file is separate. On this file, we create the index. Now, what is this index file contains? In this index file, every record has two fields. What are these fields? The index, whatever on which attribute we are going to create the index, that is called as a search key. So search key and a pointer that points to the record with that search key. So this 101, the pointer points to a record with 101. Similarly, computer science, suppose we say branch name as an index. So computer science has a search key followed by the pointer. It points to the records with the department name computer science. So that is the structure of the index, simple index, search key and the pointer. So as it includes only two fields, the search key and a pointer, and that's why typical index file is typically much smaller than the original file. Now, there are two basic type of indices, that is ordered indices and hashing. In ordered indices, again, it has three main types, primary index, secondary index, multi-level index. Primary index has two types, dense index, sparse index. Hashing has two techniques, static hashing, dynamic hashing. Along with this ordered indices and hashing, there are another two types of indices, B+3 index and B3 index. So all these we are going to study in detail in this indexing concept or in basic concept of indexing. So we are going to start with first ordered indices. Once completing this entire part, ordered indices, primary, secondary, multi-level, dense, sparse, then we will see B+3, B3 and then hashing technique. So these are the evaluation matrices on which the index depends that we have seen in the last lecture. Now ordered indices. So in ordered indices, so as its name, order. So index entries are stored in sorted order based on the search key value. Index entries are stored on sorted order based on the search key value. For example, in this,
You can see, suppose our search key is the instructor ID. Then these are index entries are stored in sorted order and accordingly the file. So you can see here these are in alpha, sorry, increasing order of the numeric value 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, increasing order of the numeric value. Means these are stored in some order according to the search key. If we say the department name as the search key, as it is an alphabetic, so these values are stored in the index, or the index entries are stored in alphabetic order B, C, E, F, H, M. Suppose I want to insert a new entry, information technology. So where I need to insert, after H, it comes information technology. If I want to insert the mechanical, so after history, it comes the mechanical before music. So index entries should be in ordered ways. Okay, so index entries are stored in sorted order based on the search key value. It has mainly two types. So initially we will see the definition and then in detail we are going to see. Primary index. In a sequential order file, normally index operate on sequential file. Hash file organization, you are going to see the hashing technique. So in a sequential order file, the index whose search key specifies the sequential order of the file. Whose search key specifies sequential order of the file. So that is the example. This search key specifies the sequential order of the entire file. So file is also stored in according to this sequence of instructor ID. Here also file is stored according to the sequence of department name. First biology, then all the instructors of computer science, then electrical, then finance, then history, then music, and then physics. Means in sequential order file, the index whose search key specifies the sequential order of the file. It is also known as clustering index. Now the search key is not necessarily primary key. The search key, not necessarily the primary key, but maximum type primary keys are used. Okay, so here you can see instructor ID is the primary key, it is used as a search key. But in this case, department name is not a primary key, but it is used as a search key. So search key may be any attribute or set of attribute, not necessarily primary key, but many times the primary key is used for indexing purpose. Now secondary index, an index whose search key specifies an order different from the sequential order of the file. So this question, such kind of question may ask for objective that which of the index whose search key specifies an order different from the sequential orders. That is secondary index, we call it as a non-clustering index. And that example we will see afterwards. Only remember that secondary index and index whose search key specifies an order different from the sequential order of the file. Now, index, as I have told that the index file is separate, okay, and the original file is separate with index record consists of two fields, search key and a pointer. Now, we are going to see the primary index in detail first and then we will see the multi-level and secondary indices. Now, the primary index, as there are mainly two types. Primary index has dense index and sparse index. So these two types we are going to see. It's a very simple concept. And most of the time this is asked for your oral and also it is asked for your theory paper. So dense index and sparse index, these are the two types of primary indices. So simple definition of dense index that its index record appears for every search key value in the file. Its index record appears for every search key in the file. So in this, primary key is used as an index record or search key. So how many number of records are there? That number of index records are here. So every search key, there is an index. For every search key, there is an index. So remember the simple definition of dense index that here the index record appears for every search key value as ID, instructor ID, attribute of this instructor represented as a search key. Another example you can see here, as I have already told that here, department name is used as a search key. So how many number of search keys are there distinct? Okay, how many distinct search keys are there? Biology is there, so that index record is present. For computer science, index record is present. For electrical, it is present. For finance, for history, for music, and for physics. For every search key, the index record appears. Everyone clear with the simple definition of dense index? Yes or no? For every search key, the index record appear in the index file. Now see here, this dense index has two types. Okay, dense clustering index and dense non-clustering index. Now what is dense clustering index? The index record contains the search key and a pointer. Okay, the index record contains a pointer. So index record contains a search key and a pointer to the first record only. To the first record with that search key. And the remaining records or the rest of the records with the same search key appears below this one. Or appears below this pointer after the first record. See once again. In dense clustering index, the index record contains a search key and a pointer that points to the first record with that search key. And the rest of the records appear after the first record. So here, computer science, this is a search key and a pointer points to the first record. Remaining records appear after it. Similarly, for finance, it points to the first record, remaining record after it. Similarly for history, similarly for music. Now see, what is dense non-clustering index? So in dense non-clustering index, the index consists of a search key and a pointer to every record with that search key. And a pointer to every record with that search key. So computer science, you can see here, there are three pointers as there are three records with the computer science. For finance, there are two pointers. For history, there are two pointers. For physics, there are two pointers. Everyone clear? Dense clustering and dense non-clustering. In dense clustering, there is a search key and a pointer points to the first record only. The remaining records appear after the first record with that search key. While in dense non-clustering index, there is an index record and with that search key and a pointer points to every record with that search key. So how many number of records with computer science, that number of pointers are available with that search key. Is it clear to everyone? Yes or no? It's a very simple concept. Okay, now we are going to see the sparse index. Then it will be clear to you what is the actual difference between sparse and dense. As in dense index, the index record appear for every search key. Means for every department name, there is a search key. What is sparse index? Sparse index contains an index record for some of the search keys, not for all the search keys. As here you can see, there is an index record for all the search keys. For every search key, there is an index record. But here you can observe there are these number of search keys, but only three index records. So sparse index contains the index record only for some of the search keys. Normally, it is considered as the block, and in that block, the first record search key is stored in the index. We consider the first record search key stored in the index. For example, suppose we consider there are five records in a block. So the first record search key is here. Now suppose in this first block, there are four records. This is the second block. From here, start the second block. Okay. This is second block, this is first block, and this is last block. Okay. So the first block, its search key is here, the first record. Then the second block start from here, so its value is stored as a search key here. And suppose five records are there and this search key appears here. In the first block, don't confuse, there are four records, means one record space is available there. So that when we insert, we can insert there. That index updation also we are going to see in detail. So everyone clear the difference between the, or what is dense index and what is sparse index? The in dense index, there is an index record for every search key, while in sparse index, the index records only for some of the search keys. So the normally, the first record in a particular block, its search key is stored in the index record. So here it is stored here it is stored here, and so we consider that this is the first block, first record of this block number two. This is the first record of the block number three. Its search key is stored in the index, and a pointer points to that particular record. So now see, the operation on this one. So the index first here, suppose we want to locate a record in the dense index. Suppose we want to locate a record in the dense index. I want to locate a record with ID 10101. Suppose I want to locate a record with ID 10101. With this ID, I want to locate a record. So how to locate a record with the indexing? So first start with okay, 101, or take another example that suppose I want to find a record with 58, with ID 58583, with instructor ID is equal to 58583. So what we need to do, start with the index, as there is an index record for every search key value. Start from here, it is in increasing order 1111. Where it is? It is here. So here we got the index record with that search key. Follow the pointer, it points to the record with that search. That is a simple process to locate a record. Another example with this kind of, where the primary key is not used as an index. Okay, here the department name is used as an index. So in that, how to locate a record with dense clustering? Suppose I want to locate a record with ID is equal to 10101 and department name is equal to computer science. Suppose I want to locate a record with ID is equal to 10101 and department name is equal to computer science. Now here in this case, what is the search key? Department name is the search key. So we need to identify the department name computer science. As it is a dense, there is an index record for every search key. So biology, it is not there. Yes, it is computer science. We can got the record here, index record with computer science. Now follow the pointer. Now it is a dense clustering index. So it points to only the first. Check whether it is, yes, ID is equal to 101, we got the record here. Now instead of this, suppose ID, computer science with ID is equal to 83821 with department name computer science. So again follow the same, first identify the index record. Here I got the index record with computer science. Now here in the dense clustering index, there is a pointer to the first record. So this pointer points to the first record with computer science. Whether it is 83821, no, go for the next record. Whether it is 83821, no, go for the next record. Yes, it is there. So we will get the record here. That is about the dense clustering index, how to locate a record. Now in the same, suppose here also I want to locate a record. I want to locate a record with ID is equal to 45565 and department name is equal to computer science. Okay, so in that case, again, the search keys are department name, that is computer science. So follow the pointer. It points to the record with that search key. Computer science, follow the pointer. Now, there is a pointer to every record. So go through this pointer. Is it to 8, 4, 5, 5, 6, 5? No. Go for the second pointer. Yes, it is there. So here we will locate the record. Everyone clear how to locate a record in the dense index? It's a very simple concept. As there is a search key for every record, follow the search key and then identify the search key and then follow the pointer. In clustering, there is a pointer to the first record. So after that, whatever the record, identify the required one. In this, there is a pointer to every record. So first follow the first pointer. If it is not there, go for the next pointer, go for the next pointer. Do you understand? Okay, now we move towards the next part, that is locate, how to locate a record in the sparse index. Now in sparse index, there is an index record for some of the search keys. There is an index record for the sum of the search keys. How to locate a record? So to see this again, we require again and again this concept. To locate a record with the search key value k, suppose we want to locate a record with the search key value k, find the index record with the largest search key value less than or equal to k. Find the index record with the largest search key value less than or equal to k. Now, for example, suppose I want to identify a record with ID is equal to 32343. Okay. So, according to this, find the index record with the largest search key value less than or equal to k. So, here it is equal to k. Okay. So, k, it is equal to the search key, it is equal to k. So 32343 we got here, it is equal to k. Then follow the pointer here. Once we follow the pointer, it points to this record. So here we will get the record with 32343. Now consider another example. Suppose I want to identify a record with ID is equal to 45565. Okay, I want to locate a record with ID is equal to 455. So, as per the rule of the simple algorithm, find the index record with the largest search key value less than or equal to k. Now, tell me which is the largest search key value less than or equal to 45565 in this index record? Write it in chat box. Write it in chat box, the index record with the largest search key value less than or equal to k. Type it in chat box. Are you there, all of you? Okay, so the largest search key value which is less than or equal to k is 32343. Then follow the pointer and sequentially search for the required record. So follow this pointer. Okay, this is the index record which is less than or equal to k. Which is less than or equal to k. Follow the pointer. Whether it is 45, no. Whether it is 455, no. Yes, it is there. Then sequentially search the records with after that pointer. Another example, suppose I want to identify a record with ID 22222. Okay, then find out the largest search key value which is less than 222. What is it? It is this one, largest search key value which is less than or equal to 22. Follow the pointer. Then search the remaining records sequentially. Is it there? Is it there? No. Yes, it is there. Everyone clear how to locate a record in the dense index and the sparse index? Now, you have to tell me the difference between the dense index and sparse index. What are the major difference between dense index and sparse index according to all these concepts? Insertion and deletion we are going to study in detail with example after this. Simple difference, tell me one or two simple differences between these two, dense and sparse index. You can unmute yourself or you can write it in chat box, the difference between these two. The major difference is that the size of the dense index, you can observe there is an index record for every search key, and that's why correct. In dense index, it requires more size than the sparse index. Okay. In dense index, there is an index record every. So if there are thousands of records in the instructor and suppose ID as a search key, then 1000 records are there in the search key. If there are 100 departments in that university, then there are 100 records in the search key or in the index. So that is the difference. There are only some records in the sparse index. So the space required by dense index is more than the space required by the sparse index. Another thing is that the it's a disadvantage of dense index and advantage of sparse index. But the advantage of dense index that as there is an index record for every search key, the time required to locate a record is less than the time required to locate a record in the sparse index. Is it clear? Here there is an index record for every search key. So suppose I want to find a record with 45565, directly go here, pointer points to that record. But here to identify 45, first I need to locate a record with the less than equal to k, follow the pointer, it is not there, go for the next, go for the next. So the time required to locate a record in the sparse index is more than the time required to locate a record in the dense index. Everyone clear with the dense and sparse index? Yes or no? So now we are going to move to the next part, that is index updation, insertion, deletion in the index. Is it clear to everyone, dense and sparse index? Now this example we are going to consider for insertion and deletion, that is updation of the index. Dense index with every record, search key for every record, sum of the records, considering that the first record search key is stored in the index, first record search key of the block stored in the index. Okay, so that is another example related to dense clustering and dense non-clustering index. Now index update. First we are going to see the insertion and then deletion with dense index and sparse index. Suppose we want to insert any record in the file. Okay, first what we need to do, perform a lookup using the search key value appear in the record to be indexed, okay, to be inserted. See, perform a lookup using the search key value appearing in the record to be inserted. First, we need to identify the location where to insert a record. First, we need to identify a location where to insert a record. Now, while insertion, if the search key already present, then we directly insert the record. If the search key already present, we can directly insert the record with that search key. Now see it with example. Suppose I want to insert a record with the search key ID is equal to something. Okay, and search key that is department name is equal to finance. Okay, see, it's an important concept, insertion. First we need to locate a record where to insert the particular, or locate the position where to insert the record with that search key. Suppose I want to insert a record with this ID and the department name is equal to finance. If the search key is already exist there, then it's a simple, then department name is equal to finance. So check whether there is a finance department in this search key. Yes. See, we are looking for dense index. There is an index record for every search key. Is there finance department? Yes. Follow the pointer. As it is a clustering index, it points to the first record only. So it is here first. This is the second record. And after this, we insert a record with ID is equal to 2 2 2 2 3, and department name is equal to fine. Okay, not necessary to do anything more. See, if the in search key already present in the index in the clustering, follow the pointer. After the last record with that search key, enter the new record. That is about this. Suppose here I want to insert a record. What I need to do first? Anyone? Suppose the same record I want to insert here. with department name is equal to finance. What I need to do first? I need to do first insert a new pointer here. Okay, I need to insert a new pointer here that points to the new record with that search key and the remaining values. So 2 2 2 2 2 3 and department name is equal to fine. Everyone clear with the dense index insertion? See, if the search key is already there, then follow the pointer in the clustering and after the last record enter the next record whatever given. In non-clustering, first we need to add a pointer with that search key and then add a record after the last record. If the search key is present there, if the search key is not present there, for example, suppose I want to insert a record with department name is equal to mechanical. Okay, I want to insert a record with department name is mechanical. Now search, as it is a dense, there should be an index record for every search key. Is there may? No. What I need to do here? First, I need to insert a record with that search key in index. So where it comes in alphabetic order? After history and before music. After history and before music, I need to insert a record with mechanical. And one pointer here I need to insert, and that pointer points to the record after where to I need to insert after music. Sorry, before music, after history. So here that pointer points. Okay. And here I insert a record with department name is equal to mechanic after the history. Is it clear? Yes or no? In the same way here, I want to insert a record with department name mechanical. It comes after the history before make. Add a pointer and after history the record is inserted. As is a sequential file, if there is a no space, it is inserted in the overflow block and then the reorganization of the file is performed periodically to keep it in sequential order. Is it clear? Insertion in the dense index? Yes or no? Or need to repeat? Yes or no? I think now all are you there. So that is about the insertion in the dense index, clustering and non-clustering. Now suppose I want to insert a record in the sparse index. I want to insert a record in the sparse index. If the index stores an entry for each block of the file, as I have told that the first record is entry stored in the index. If it not create a new block, simply insert the record at the end. For example, suppose I want to insert a record with the search key ID is equal to 25555. Suppose I want to insert a record with this. Now, how first I need to locate a record or locate a space where to insert the record. For that, we identify the index record, record whose search key value is less than or equal to 25555. Now, identify index record with the search key less than or equal to 555. It is this one. Okay, it is this one. So, follow the pointer and check whether there is a space to insert a record. So I told that we consider that 5 records in one block. So follow the pointer. Is there space in this block to insert this ID 255? 1, 2, 3, 4. There are only 4 records. So after this last record, where we need to keep put it in the sequential order after 2 2 2 2. So where it goes? It goes here. Here I need to insert a record with the index 255555 or search key 2555. Not necessary to do anything. not necessary to update the index, not necessary to do anything. I see another example. Suppose I want to insert a record with ID, with ID. Okay, so find out the index record which is less than or equal to 89000. What is that index record which is less than or equal to 8900? This one. Follow the pointer. Okay, now in this block we can consider there are 5 records in one block. Now there are only 3 records, means we can insert this here. Where to insert it? In sequential order. So where it goes? It goes after 83821 and before 98. So here I need to insert a record with this one. I write it here 89000. Not necessary to update anything in the index. Directly insert the value. Everyone clear? So that I can move to the next. Now see here, suppose I want to insert, repeat. Now suppose I want to insert another example with ID 76666. Okay, with ID is equal to 76666. Now tell me what here required. Where it goes? Find out the index record which is less than or equal to 76666. Less than or equal to 7666. So what is that which is less than 76666? Find out an index record which is less than or equal to 76666. What is that? Be fast. Okay, so it is 32343. Okay, find out the index record which is less than or equal to this one. Less than or equal to this one. So 32343. Follow the pointer. And then where to insert it? In sequential order after 76563. But as I have already said that there are only 5 records in a file, in a block. Now there are already 5 records in a block. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 and 5. Now there is no space in this block to insert a new record with this ID. So what we need to do? We need to insert it into the next block. So where it comes? It comes here. We comes here, that is 76666. Now what happens here? It becomes the first record of the block. Now it becomes the first record of the block. So what we need to do here? We need to update the index. We need to update the index. We need to remove it. And at this place, we need to insert 76666. We write it here 7666666, and then the pointer points to the first record or the record with that search key 7666. Is it clear to everyone? See, once again I am repeating this part. Suppose I want to insert a record. Suppose I want to insert a record with ID is equal to 76666. So identify a index record which is less than or equal to this ID. So 32343. Follow the pointer, and here in this block I am going to insert a record, but the block is already full as there are 5 records, means I need to insert into the next block. So when I insert into the next block, it becomes the first record of the next block. It becomes the first record of the next block, that is here I need to insert. And as the first record change, I need to update the index also. I need to update the index also. So remove it, and instead of that I keep here the new value, that is 760, and follow the pointer to this new record. Okay, this pointer now points to the first record 76. So in that case, we need to update the index also. In this case, previously it is not required. Everyone clear? The insertion in the sparse index and insertion in the dense index. Now we move towards the next, that is deletion. Deletion in the dense and sparse index. So delete a record, the system first look up the record to be deleted, where that record is actually stored. If the deleted record, okay, we will see it with example. Okay. Suppose we want to delete a record. I will directly show you here the example. I want to delete a record with, I write it here. Name is equal to cards. Okay, different cases we will see. Name is equal to cards and department name is equal to computer science. Okay, suppose I want to delete a record with this name is equal to cards and department name is equal to computer science. As there is a search key on department name, then identify the search key. It is a dense index, so there is an index record for every search key. So identify the department name equal to computer science. It is there. Follow the pointer. As it is a clustering, the pointer points to the first record. Whether it is name is equal to cards? No. It is? Yes. Follow the next record. Yes, it is there. Delete it. Simply delete the record from here. Not necessary to change anything in the index. Have you understood? Now same, if we apply here, suppose I want to delete a record with name is equal to cards and department equal to computer science, then identify first department computer science, follow the first pointer. Whether it is cards, no. Follow the second pointer, yes, it is there. So for that first, what we need to do? First delete this pointer. Why? There is a pointer to every record. So first delete this pointer and then delete the record from this file with name is equal to card. Is it clear to everyone? With name is equal to card. That is the simple. Not necessary to do anything with the index. Now we will see another example. Suppose so many case studies you can refer here. Name is equal to Srinivasan and department name is equal to computer science. Name is equal to Srinivasan. So first department name as a search key, follow the pointer, search key, identify it is computer science. First it is the record with Srinivasan I want to delete. So before, after deleting this record, suppose I delete the record, what I need to change here? Now the pointer points to the next record with that search key. As of considering the first. Okay, so this pointer I need to update. Why? Because I deleted the first record. So I need to update the pointer also. In this case, suppose I want to delete, then follow the pointer first record S. Delete the pointer, delete the record. Not necessary to do anything with. Everyone clear? Not necessary to do anything else with this. Already there is a pointer to the next record, but here we need to update the pointer, point to the next record with that search key. That is about the, if there are multiple record with that search key. If there are multiple record with that search key. Now, if there is a single record with that search key, if there is a, see another example, if there is a single record with that search key, I want to delete a record with name is equal to Mozart and department name is equal to music. What happens here? Okay, suppose I want to delete the record with name is equal to Mozart and department name is equal to music. Then in that case, identify a record with the index record with the department name music. Follow the pointer. Now what happens here? there is a single record with the department. If I delete this record, what along with that I need to delete the index entry also. I want to delete the index entry also. Same case is here. Suppose I want to delete a record with this music, first identify, follow the pointer. If I delete the record with this one, it is a single record with that search key, and that's why I need to delete the search key from the index also. Is it clear? So always remember, if there are multiple record with that search key, only we need to delete the record. But if there is a single record with that search key, along with the record, we need to delete the index record also with that search key. So I think it is clear to everyone, as I have considered all different type of cases. Now we move towards the sparse index in the case of deletion. So again, in the sparse index, it is simple. Again, we look up record. If the search key value does not appear in the index, if the index does not contain the index record with the search key value, delete record, simply not necessary to do anything. Okay, now see here again with the case study. For example, suppose we consider I want to delete a record with ID is equal to 15151. First make a lookup, identify a record where it is stored. For that, follow the pointer with the index record less than or equal to 1515. So 1515, it is 1010, which is less than or equal to 15. Follow the pointer. Is it 1515? No. It is 1515? No. It is there. So delete it. Not necessary to do anything. Everyone clear? See another example. Suppose I want to delete a record with ID is equal to 45565. Identify the index record which is less than or equal to 45565. Then in that case, this one is less than or equal to 45. Follow the pointer. Is this 45565? No. Is this? Yes, it is there. So delete a record from this file. Not necessary to do anything. Now the next one. Suppose I want to delete another case. ID is equal to 767666. Now identify the index record which is less than or equal to 76766. So it is there. It is equal to 766. Okay. So follow the pointer. Now we delete the record. Now as the record is deleted, what happens here? This record is deleted with that search key, means also we need to update the index. We need to delete this search key from the index. What we need to add here? We need to add the next record search key here, as this becomes the first record in the block. So here I need to update the index with the new search key 83821. Is it clear, everyone? See, once again, suppose I want to insert a record with 76766. Identify the index record, follow the pointer, and delete the record. Once I delete the record, this search key no longer exists in the file, so I need to delete it from the index, or I need to update the index. So what we need to add into the index? The search key of the next record. What we need to add into the index? The search key of the next record, that is 83821. So in this way, along with the insertion and deletion of the records in the file, in some of the cases, we need to update the index always. So as I have told you so many cases, I think it is clear to you the index updation, insertion and deletion. Next lecture, we will see the multi-level index, secondary index and the remaining part. The last lecture. Now we will see the multi-level index. So multi-level index, in multi-level index, as its name, now suppose this is our primary index. For example, this is our primary index. So in dense index, normally there is a search key value for every record, correct? There is a search key value for every record.
So these search key value, suppose there are, suppose thousands of records, then there are thousands of search key value in the index. So that example, I will give you another example. Suppose, for example, there are 1 lakh records. There are 1 file, suppose there are 1 lakh records. There are 1 lakh records, and we consider that for 100 records in one block. So tell me how many blocks are there to store this record? See, once again, suppose we consider there are 1 lakh records. There are 1 lakh records, and in one block we can store 10 records. Sorry, not 100, 10 records. Then how many blocks are required to store this particular file? Have you understood my question? So you have to write it in chat box. We consider that there are 1 lakh records and 10 records. See, be fast as we are lagging behind in syllabus. So 10,000 records. So 10 records in one block. If we consider 10 records in one block, then how many blocks we require? Total 10,000 blocks are required. Total 10,000 blocks are required. Now we consider that we are using a sparse index. We are considering that we are using a sparse index. And for one block, as I all told that, at one block, one index record is there. One block, one index record is there. Whatever the first record, its search key is stored in the index. See, once again, there are 1 lakh records we consider in a file, and 10 records in one block. So 10,000 blocks are required. As we consider it is a sparse index, then one block, and we store one block, one index record. So how many total index records are there? How many total index records are there? Total 10,000 blocks. Per block, one index record. So simple, it has 10,000 index records. 10,000 index records. Now what are these 10,000 index records? Suppose we consider that 100 index records stored in one block. These are also stored. See, index files are also stored in the database that already I have told you. We consider that as there are total 10,000 index records. Depending on that search key, suppose there are 10,000 index records, and we consider that 100 records stored, index records stored in one block. Why we consider 100? Because the index record size is smaller than the original file. So we consider that 100 records stored in one block. So total how many blocks are required to store the index? Anyone? Have you understood my question? I am again repeating. We consider there are 1 lakh records in the file. 10 records in one block. So total 10,000 blocks are required. Now we consider it is a sparse index. One block, one index record. The first record we consider as the index record. So one block, one index record means total how many index records are there? 10,000 index records are there. Now index file is smaller than the original file, and that's why consider 100 index records are stored in one block. 100 index records are stored in one block. So how many total blocks are required to store the index? Anyone? 100, correct. So 100 blocks are required to store this index. Entire index, we require 100 blocks. Now see, as the size of main memory is very small, the size of main memory is very small. So storing these 100 of blocks in the main memory, it is not possible. And that's why means the primary index itself becomes very large. The primary index itself becomes very large with 100 blocks. With 100 blocks. So in that case, what happens? These are stored as a secondary, means as a part, we create another index on the primary index. So in this case, what happens? The primary index becomes very large. The primary index becomes very large. So in that case, we create another index on the primary index. We create another index on the primary index. Okay. And then that primary index, what we call it as a inner index. It is inner index, and the index that is created. Okay. The index that is created, sorry, on this primary index, it is we call outer index, or what we call it as a outer index. If this outer index is also very large, then we create another kind of index on it. Then we create another kind of index on it. If it is again large one. So in this way, do it until the outer index becomes small to fit in the main memory. Is it clear to everyone? And these kind of indices, inner index, outer index, outer index, it is known as multi-level index. It is known as multi-level index. Everyone clear or need to repeat? How we define a multi-level index? If a primary index does not fit in memory, access becomes expensive. Okay. So number of blocks are created, not possible to fit in main memory. So solution is to treat the primary index as a separate sequential pile and create an outer index, which is again type of sparse index. So inner index, we call it as a primary index, and on which we create outer index. Even if the outer index is too large to fit in main memory, yet another level of index can be created, and so on. So indices in this way created, we call it as a multi-level index, and that is shown here in this particular diagram. It is original file, okay, on which we create the inner index. As in our example, I have told that is it visible screen? I think sharing has been stopped. So here, as I told that, suppose this is the original file. This is original file with 1 lakh records. 1 lakh records. Then as it is a big one, the number of blocks for the index required are 10,000. Okay. One block, one index. So 10,000 are there, suppose. Now these 10,000 blocks required to store the index is very big. So we create another level of index, that is outer index. Everyone clear? Inner index, outer index. If it is again big, create another one. Now how to locate a record with the multi-level indices? So to locate a record in the multi-level indices, we always start with the outer index. We always start with the outer index. Now outer index is always sparse index. It is. Inner index may be sparse or dense, but outer index is always a sparse index. Outer index is always a sparse index. So if we want to locate a record, we first do a search, find out the record with the search key value less than or equal to we desire. Less than or equal to we design. Suppose we consider here the record 10101, and we are looking for the ID 12121. और 12020. सो फाइंड आउट द सर्च की वैल्यू लार्जेस्ट. सपोज हियर इट इज notation has stopped. Okay, suppose it is 10101 and here the record store is 32320 and we are searching for the record 12121. So as already I have told that in the sparse index we find out the record index record with the search key value less than or equal to the required. So less than or equal to is 10101. So follow the pointer. Follow the pointer. It points to here. Then this is our outer index. Now in this find out the record. If it is a dense, there is an index record for every. If it is sparse, then find out the record index record with the search key value less than or equal to 1 to 1. If it is there, then follow the pointer and this will give you this record and this will give you this record in this block. Is it clear? It's a simple concept of multi-level indices. Now the secondary index. Next part of the index is the secondary index. So secondary index, the definition of primary index is that it specifies the order or sequential order of the file. It specifies the sequential order of the file. Now what is the definition of secondary index? Whose search key specifies the order other than the sequential order? Whose search key specifies the order other than the sequential order? So in the secondary index, that it must be a dense index. See, one of the property of secondary index is that it must be a dense index. It never a sparse index. With an index means every there is an index record for every search key value and a pointer to every record in the file. Pointer to every record in the file, it is a non-clustering dense index. There is a pointer to every record in the file. So always remember these two properties, that the secondary indices specifies an order other than the sequential order. And we can have a secondary index which must be a dense with an index record for every search key value and a pointer to every record in the file. Now there is another concept of secondary index, that along with the index record and its a pointer, this pointer points to a bucket, and that bucket contains the pointer to all actual records with that particular search key. Means there is another level, that is bucket level. Now see it with the diagram, then it becomes simple. This is the file of instructor file, and we create the index on salary. Suppose we create the index on the salary. So here it is a dense index, means every search key value appears in the index record. Every search key value appears in the index record, and there is a pointer that points to another level, that is a bucket, and the bucket contains a pointer that points to the record with that search key value. That pointer points to the record with that search key value. So here see 40,000. So this 40,000, it points to the bucket. Now this bucket contains a pointer that points to the record with 40,000 salary. Similarly, 60,000 points to a bucket with salary 60,000. Now here you can observe that 80,000, there are two persons with the salary 80,000. So this one and this one. Okay. Singh in finance department has salary 80,000 and Kim in electrical engineering department has salary 80,000. So there is a single record for this search key 80,000 points to a bucket. Now there are two records and therefore there are two buckets. First bucket points to the record with 80,000 salary and second record points to the bucket with 80,000. No, correct. It is not in sequential order according to the search key, and that's why sequential, whose secondary index whose search key value specifies an order other than the sequential order. That's why its definition is like this. I think it is clear to everyone with the secondary indices. Now here we complete the primary index, secondary index and multi-level index.